So we are discussing moment of a force. Let me just put that. And to begin with, we are examining the idea of torque. Okay. So what is a torque? So we are taking a system of a door as seen from above, cross section, rigid support, hinge door, and handles on both sides. Now, what you can do, the reason why we put handles on the outside, there is something to it, okay? And that is that when we want to open or close a door, we will apply a force on the handle. Okay, you'll hold the handle, you probably twist it and then give it a push or a pull depending upon, you know, what you're expected to do. I call that force the force F1, the one that acts in that direction and then causes the door to swing. Now, I could apply the same amount of force out here. Okay, I call this at position A and I call this at position B. So now my question would be, is there any difference in applying the force, the same force F1 at position A and position B? Is there a difference?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So why is there a difference?
Again, it's like the circle ka example only, just that it's a door this time.
Sorry?
It's like the circle example only. The A, it's greater distance from the point of point of rotation, basically the pivoted point.
Yeah, but in terms of you applying a force and the door opening and closing, how does it matter whether you apply the force at A or you apply the force at B? In fact, it seems it will make more sense to apply at B because you have to apply the force for a shorter time before the door opens, right? Whereas if it's at A, the distance has to be longer, whereas at B, the distance, okay, that doesn't actually make sense. But in terms of your effort, yeah, actually what I said did make sense, because let's say that the door opened to this extent, okay, with the doorknob and all that. If you had been applying a force at B, then your force kind of will be there and your force kind of will be here for F1. And the distance for which you would have applied the force would have been greater than the distance for which you applied over here.
You need to put more effort at B.
You need to put more effort at B. Why do you say so? Did you try it? Anybody who's finding this difficult to figure out, what you do, go to the nearest door and try this. Try pushing the door at point A where, I mean, you may or may not have a doorknob, but even if you have a handle, you'll see that even handles are placed closer to the edge opposite to the hinge. And then try pushing it a little inwards. In fact, take it to the absurd extreme. Okay. Try pushing it very close to the hinge. That's one way in which you can test out these notions. Reductio ad absurdum. Take it to the extreme and then push at the hinge. A little bit from point A to point B, if the distance is not great, you won't actually feel much. But the more and more closer you get to the hinge, you'll start to feel the effect more and more. So if you tried this out, can you tell me what is it that you are experiencing?
it gets harder and harder as you come closer to the hinges. It gets harder to push.
Yeah, and in fact, if you are pushing at the hinge, which is the most dumb thing.
Yeah, you can't push.
You can't do anything. You can't get the door to even budge a bit, right? Just near to the hinge also with a great amount of effort, your finger might look like it's going to like break off like that, right? At that point, you may find the door still starts to move a little bit. But if you push at the hinge, right, no amount of force will be sufficient to close. I mean, you can apply, if you're Superman or something, you can apply a tremendous amount of force and break the hinge and the door. But I mean, the hinge will break because the bolt will, the nuts will, the screws will come out. But that's a different thing. None of us will be able to do that. So what does this tell you about applying a force? Why does it become easy to open the door if you apply the same force at the end? Or you can say that I can cause the door to open a lot easier by applying the force over here than over here. If I have to do it by applying a force over here at this position particularly, then I have to apply a very high amount of force to cause the same thing to happen. I have to apply a very large amount of force, some X quantity of force. Okay, and in answering that, we'll discuss this a little bit because it's important to talk about this. And in answering that, we will come to the concept of moment of a force. Okay, so is there any questions? I just heard the bell, so we'll have to stop in a few minutes. So if you have any questions or doubts, please ask now. So what we kind of discussed prior to this in terms of the background, that was when objects undergo rotational motion, right? Then what are the different factors that you need to keep in mind? So now we are looking at what causes rotational motion to take place in the first place. So you see that the door opening is actually an example of a rotational motion. There is an axis that goes through the hinge and then the door rotates. Now, the door will rotate only if there is an external force that is applied on it, right? So now we are seeing the nature of this external force is such that when you apply a force further and further away from the axis of rotation, its effectiveness in terms of causing the rotational motion to occur seems to become better. And the closer you come to the hinge, you need to, in order to cause the same amount of acceleration, angular acceleration, a much larger amount of force needs to be applied. Why is that the case? Okay, so that's the key question to answer over here. Now, if there aren't any further questions, then we can stop now.